again, do it again in my life. Me not a gentle savior, am I open grand? Why art thou art holy? Jesus, 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 Jesus. Hallelujah. Savior, 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 Savior. Savior, Savior, Savior. My humble cry. made impossibility possible.
He made impossibility possible.
Jehovah Jireh,
he made impossibility possible.
Jehovah Elohim,
he made impossibility possible.
Jehovah Shammah,
he made impossibility possible.
Jehovah Nissi,
he made impossibility possible.
Jehovah Jireh,
he made impossibility possible.
Jehovah Elohim,
he made impossibility possible.
Jehovah Nissi,
Jehovah Elohim,
Jehovah Shammah,
he made impossibility possible.
I've been to Calvary, I did my hands in the blood of the Lamb. I did the blood of Jesus. My life has been made. I've been to Calvary,
I've been to Calvary, I've been to Calvary. I've been the blood of Jesus.
My life
has been made.
My life has been made.
My life has been made.
My life has been made
whole.
My life has been made whole.
My life has been made
whole. My life has been made whole.
My life has been made whole.
I've been to Calvary.
I've been to Calvary.
Oh yes,
I lay my hand in the blood of the Lamb. I drink the blood of Jesus. My life has been made whole.
Jesus Boko Sibiri. Oh yeah, you were the way. Shout hallelujah!
Hey, hallelujah!
All eyes closed. The Spirit of the Living God and the power that has no respect for any enemy. Within the last few seconds, we begin to move about in the mist. And in the movement in the mist, certain situations that have embarrassed and disgraced some people will be shaken out instantly. Let there be silence now. I decree upon that sister over there that the witchcraft decision over your marriage, the witchcraft decision over your children, the witchcraft decision over your body is broken right now in the name of Jesus. That's the first person. That's the second person. Yes, that's the power of God coming upon you. Silence. These three sisters there, hear this heavenly decree. The cage.
I go.
Holding your divine spouse is broken now. In the name of Jesus. That's the first sister. That's the second one. That's the third one. Thank you, Jesus. Father, we are gathered there tonight.
Baba, we know
that your power is the absolute power. You have never failed, you will never fail. As many of your children as are gathered there tonight, meet them at the point of their needs in the name of Jesus. Open our understanding, O Lord. Thank you, Heavenly Father. With a voice that roars like thunder. Sing this song loud and clear. In any language that you know it. But just sing it loud and clear. If you don't know the chorus, sing the body loud and clear. If you don't know the body, sing the chorus loud and clear. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. That great physician is there. That superfanidaro. The voice of Jesus. Speak the Lord in Sarah. Speak the name on God's throne. Speak the sky, ruler, pastor. Sweetest note, sweetest note, sweetest note in Sarah. Sweetest name on mother's tongue. Sweetest God, ruler of song. Jesus, blessed sing it the third time now, sweet as love, sweet as sweet as rain on the mountain, sweet as God, ruler of song, Jesus, blessed Father,
Baba,
in that power as a great physician, move in our midst tonight in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Heavenly Father. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Let's have a sing, God bless you. In Luke chapter 4, verse 18. Gospel according to St. Luke, chapter 4, verse 18, connecting the great physician. Luke 4:18. If you are there, say yes. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me. This is Jesus speaking. Because he had anointed me. Number 1. To preach the gospel to the poor. Number 2. He has sent me to heal the broken hearted. Number three, to preach deliverance to the captives. Number four, recovery of sight to the blind. Number five, to set at liberty them that are bruised. And lastly, to preach the acceptable year of the Lord. There are seven major sicknesses. Seven major sicknesses. One, spiritual sickness. That is sickness of the spirit. That sickness of the spirit can also be a source of other problems in the body or soul. If the spirit man is sick, there is 100% chance that the body and soul will be sick. And this is generally caused by sin. That's why Jesus said to that man by the pool of Bethesda,
said,
sin no more, lest a worse thing come upon you. I'm praying for anyone here tonight that you are passing through some infirmity now because of a spiritual sickness you have had. Father, let the blood of Jesus wipe away that spiritual sickness in the name of
Jesus.
Spiritual sickness also includes spiritual weakness.
That
is lack of spiritual appetite. You don't have appetite for the things of the spirit. If a person is sick physically, he may not have appetite for food. If a person is sick spiritually, he will lack appetite for spiritual things. He will not enjoy Bible study. He will not enjoy prayer. He will carry out all type of tricks to escape fasting. That lack of spiritual appetite is a serious sign of spiritual sickness. You can have a spiritual diabetes.
That is
all you want is sugar, 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 sugar. All the sermons you want to listen to is one of prosperity, motivation, getting business, moving forward. But when somebody begins to discuss that there is a way that leads to life, it is narrow. There is another way that leads to hellfire, it is wide. You don't like hearing those kind of things at all. It is spiritual diabetes. Unfortunately, nobody grows on just sugar alone. Unfortunately, our major sickness in the church today is this spiritual diabetes. Sugar, 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 sugar When you are almost dead, somebody is telling you are moving forward. Somebody's leg is broken. And I say you are going forward. I say you are going forward. Right now. Right now you are going forward. I say you are going forward. And you say, yeah. So if you are going forward, say you. When the legs are already broken, how will he run? Diabetes. Jesus did not say you are the sugar of the earth. He said you are the salt of the earth. If you put 10 cubes of sugar in your mouth, you can keep it there.
It
won't do you any harm apart from your body. But you put a teaspoon of salt in your mouth and close your mouth, you will find what you to do to that man before you spit it out. That is what we're supposed to be, salt, not sugar. You could be suffering from spiritual kwashoko. That is, word of God, zero. Prayer, zero. Pass, zero. So you have grown so lean in the spirit. When spirit husband say, come here, you rush there. When they give you food, you eat. If they pursue you, you run. Because you are suffering from spiritual kwashoko. You have no strength. You can have spiritual malaria. That is today hot. Tomorrow cold. Today on fire. Next day on ice water. Just like malaria does.
And
sometimes some people will have malaria. Temperature will just go up.
And
it comes down again. Same thing in spirit. On fire for God one day. On ice water the other day.
It's
a sign of spiritual sickness. A sister left our meeting one day and prayed that prayer we used to give to them to take home. And any power that want to attack me as a result of my prayer here tonight, die in the name of Jesus. She prayed the prayer. As he was praying, God opened her eyes. And some short creatures came to her and they started laughing. They laughed. So when he saw these small creatures,
he said,
who are you people? I bind in the name of Jesus. The creatures laughed more. They laughed until they fell down. Then when they stood up, everybody is binding.
You
are binding. How can you bind us?
We are
in you and you are in us. I'm praying for somebody here. Any power that has bound your spiritual hand, so you cannot fight in the spirit realm, I bind that power in the name of
God.
A sound for them. Obviously,
that you
can see that the spiritual sickness I'm describing now, no doctor can help you. No drugs can help you. There's nothing they can do. It's just like somebody goes to the hospital. I said,
doctor,
what tablet can you give me against fornication?
None.
Just like there is no x-ray that can detect the eaters of flesh and drinkers of blood in the body. So really, By the time we remove spiritual sicknesses, all others are very little. It is there many things originate. I'm praying one more time. But anyone in this manna water service tonight who has been spiritually dwarfed, receive your deliverance in the name of Jesus. It is a sign of spiritual sickness. When in your dream, somebody comes, take, eat.
Yeah.
Say, but I don't eat pork.
It's
okay, you don't want pork?
All
right. This is crocodile meat. Eat this one. Don't you have cow meat? Don't you have chicken? Say no. We don't have those things. Eat crocodile. Eat pork.
Say,
I don't want to eat.
Say,
we command you to eat it now. I begin to eat. Spiritual sickness. I remember my friend today. My friend. That my friend, before he received fire, anytime he had something important to do, a day before that thing, somebody will bring palm wine and they will feed him with palm wine. By the time he wakes up, he will still be feeling the taste of the palm wine. Anytime he had that dream, he knew that anything he was going to do next day would fail. I'm praying for somebody here. If you have a trigger dream like that, a dream that triggers failure, I cancel that dream right now in the name of
Jesus.
He's been having these dreams. He will pray. Unfortunately, not serious prayers. Because as of that time, nobody taught us the kind of prayers we're praying now. All we know to do is that when there is a problem, you start reading the psalm. It was going like that. Then his wedding day was approaching. A night before the wedding, they brought the palm wine again. They fed him with it. He fought them. Say, I don't want. So the way they force feed baby to drink pap when the babies don't want to eat,
bi won se ma ro omo wo ni eko.
They carried him and force fed him. They closed his nose and put it into his mouth. That is spiritual weakness. The wedding day came. On their way to the wedding program, the vehicle they had, they were coming with had accident. And it was a serious problem. Fortunately, nothing happened to him. Apart from the fact that his wedding dress was now very dirty. So he changed to that of the best man. And the best man looked for something else to wear. On the way to church now again, close to the place, a man riding a motorbike or car ran into him. He fell into the gutter again with the white suit. Meanwhile, the bride was in church crying. The wedding that was supposed to start at 9 o'clock, 12 noon, my friend was not in church.
I'm
praying once again that anyone who has any spiritual weakness that the enemy is now using as a tool to pursue your destiny, receive your healing now in the name of
Jesus.
That amen is not loud enough. The amen is still not loud enough.
Ikeji.
That is emotional sickness.
Aisan inu ero o wa.
This one is caused by hurting or damaging emotions.
Ogbe okan lo ma nfa eleyi.
This is generally caused
eleyi okun fa re
by what happens to us
ni awon ohun to ba sele si wa
or what is done to us.
Abi ohun ti won se si wa.
A lady
omobirin kan
when we were in Old Yaba Road came and she came for counseling. And she said, I need prayer. Say, because I hate men. They are all animals. I hate men. God should just remove all the men from this planet. She said she doesn't want to marry again. She's not interested. What happened? Why? We didn't know that some time ago. Her parents sent her to go and marry one man abroad.
Who
was the man that said they should bring her? But when she got there,
he
was at the airport. The man said, are you the person they sent to me? Say yes. Say no. No. Your photograph that I was seeing here, you were not this short.
Oh, kuru to ba yinu re ke.
This thing.
Wo?
Who sent this thing to me?
Talo no kini si mi.
Who sent this thing to me?
Talo kini si mi.
Go back.
Pada sohun.
From that time,
lati gba yen lo,
rejection enter into our soul.
Ikosile o wonu okan re.
Depression enter into our soul.
Iteba okan o wonu okan re.
That is emotional sickness.
Aisan ninu ero.
All the crying diarrhea.
Gbogbo ekun asun da.
Crying. Any small thing they break down, crying. Ni
ko kere ba ti sele won bere si wa mi loju.
Emotional sickness.
Aisan
some are easily upset.
Elomiran inu won ma tete baje.
This small thing they upset.
Okan won tete daru.
They have instability or imbalance of their emotions.
Ninu ero won sege sege wa nbe.
There is emotional sickness.
Aisan inu ero.
Something is wrong somewhere.
Ohun kan o se dede nibi kan.
Wrong somewhere.
Ohun kan o se dede.
And I want you to understand this.
O se fe kele iye yi.
We pray with a sister.
Agbadura fun arabirin kan.
She had HIV.
O ni arun ti o gbogun.
Where, how did she get HIV? She said this man came. The man said she has HIV. But you must help me.
So
what kind of help? Say I love you. I want to sleep with you. But you just said you have HIV.
Go away.
Say the man now started crying. I was rolling on the floor. And I felt sorry for him. That was how she collected the extra luggage. She's sick.
Oh, she is sick.
But it's another kind of sickness.
Three.
There is mind sickness.
Aisan inu okan.
At least the mind becomes sick.
Okan o nse aisan.
The will,
ife inu,
the intellect,
opolo
functions abnormally.
Yo ma sise lodi lodi.
Dirty minds.
Okan to dirty.
Ungodly imaginations.
Awon ero ti o ba Olorun mu.
Unprogressive thinking.
Ironu ti o ni tesiwaju.
Mind blindness.
Okan to sofo.
Mind blankness.
Okan to daduro.
Mind that cannot cease to think evil.
Okan ti o le sala ero ibi.
mind sickness. So many minds are sick like that. Very, very sick. Intensively sick. Sick mind. Four. The normal sicknesses of the body. That is, the man is not feeling well. Most of these problems in the body have their root in organic or functional disorder of the body. One organ of the body is not working properly. One organ is failing. Those are the normal physical sicknesses of the body. Five. There is demonic sicknesses. By demonic sicknesses, we mean any sickness sponsored by evil spirits. The sicknesses are there. The person is feeling strange.
But
all medical tests have been carried out. And everything comes out normal. No problem. Scan, okay. Blood test, okay.
Everything,
okay. X-ray, okay. But the person knows that it's not well. These are demonically sponsored sicknesses. I'm praying for somebody here. Any sickness sponsored by the devil, I command them to depart in the name of Jesus. Under this section, that I'm discussing with you, this section number 5,
is
what you have, what the Bible calls spirits of infirmity. They can stay undetected for years. They are strangers in the body. They can disfigure a person. They can cause untold suffering. They have no respect for medicine. They create internal bondages. They create spiritual chains. And they can kill prematurely. For them to go requires being loosed from their bondage.
And
requires the hand of Jesus. They can go to, with somebody to church. And they just remain there. They won't bother to go.
They
just be there harassing the person. Remember the story of that woman who went to the temple. The Bible said it was bent double. Bent double. In medicine, they have a name for that kind of sickness. They may say it's weaknesses of the spinal bone. So this bone is weak. So because of that, the person cannot stand straight. So the person is bending. But they did not know that it was more than that. This woman was physically ill. But one fantastic thing about that woman, that she never stopped going to church. She didn't give up the prayer meetings. If she had stopped going to the prayer meetings, she would not have met Jesus the other day. Because I don't think Jesus ever went back there again. Apart from that one day that she met her. But nobody knows. They didn't know that the hidden hand of Satan was in that bondage. They didn't know that the enemy can tie a rope around a person's life for as long as 18 years.
fun odun mejidinlogun.
But the glorious thing about this woman
is
that the agency of the devil, they did not know that they were preparing the woman for a glorious testimony, that the old world would be reading. Our chronic enemies were our unfriendly friends. Because even after Jesus had healed, that they were complaining. Instead of rejoicing that the woman has been made whole, they said, Jesus, why should you heal her on the Sabbath day? I'm praying for somebody here. Every rage of unfriendly friends against your life shall scatter in the name of Jesus.
You to Jesus.
Number six. Is sicknesses unto death. Sicknesses sponsored by the spirit of death and hell. Their agenda is to kill. We call them terminators. They are sponsored by the spirit of death and hell. They bring oppression. They bring infirmity. They introduce spirit of death and hell. They use witchcraft powers. They use evil pronouncements. They use familiar spirits. They use the sun, the moon, and the stars. They use fear and worry. They use the drinkers of blood and eaters of flesh. They use the spirit of murder. They use the spirit of suicide. They use the curse of family destruction. They use evil summon. Person with Jason, they are calling you, but you don't know
who's
calling you. Bad food. They use environmental bondages. They use poison, physical or spiritual. They use ancestral bondages. That is sicknesses unto death. I want to make a pronouncement now. As many people as who let their amen break the gates of hell will receive that touch. I'm praying for anyone here. If there is any sickness unto death in the body, I send them back to the senders in the name of
Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
Seventh one is destiny sicknesses.
Ni awon aisan ayomo.
Destiny sickness.
Awon aisan ayomo.
That is career sickness.
Aisan ise.
Labor sickness.
Aisan la.
Effort sickness.
Aisan iyanju.
Talent sickness.
Aisan talenti.
Blockage.
It did not.
Nothing works.
Those
are destiny sicknesses. So, beloved, seven categories of sicknesses. Spiritual sicknesses. Emotional sicknesses. Mind sicknesses. Normal sicknesses of the body. Demonic sicknesses. Sicknesses unto death. And destiny sicknesses. Those are the seven major sicknesses. Now,
why?
Jesus referred to himself as a physician or a doctor.
Jesus
gave remarkable attention to healing.
O fi akoko sile lati gbajumo oro ise iwosan ni sise.
This is why they call him the great physician.
Idi ni yan ti won fi npe ni onisegun nla.
And the good physician.
Ati onisegun rere.
That's why they call him great physician.
Idi ni yan ti won fi npe ni onisegun nla.
Good physician.
Ati onisegun rere.
The first reason that he called himself a doctor, a physician.
Ni pe o pe ra re ni dokita onisegun.
Jesus gave remarkable attention to healing.
Jesus gbajumo oro ise iwosan ni sise.
Jesus healed all who were brought to him.
Gbogbo awon eni ti won pe wa ba Jesus fun iwosan lo mu larada.
Then the healing power of Jesus
agbara iwosan Jesus
touches every level of our existence.
Gbogbo ipele igbe aye wa lokan
as a human being.
Gege bi eniyan.
Whether it's physical,
iba se tara,
whether it's emotional,
iba se tero,
whether it's social,
iba se ti awujo,
whether it's spiritual,
iba se temi.
The threefold ministry of Jesus.
Ise oni pele meta ti Jesus se.
He came to save.
De pe o wa lati wosan.
To heal.
O wa lati gbala. O wa lati wosan. Ati lati tu sile.
Three.
Meta ni.
To save.
Lati gbanila.
To heal.
Lati wonisan.
To deliver.
Ati lati dani ni de.
Jesus is called the great physician.
An pe Jesus ni onisegun nla.
He has no respect for hospital cases.
Nitori ko bowo fun oro kan pe ile iwosan lo le da si.
Let me share this testimony with you.
E je so ijeri ifun yin.
1993 I think.
Lodun 1993.
A sister in this church was sick.
Arabinrin kan ninu ijo yi o se isan.
That was 1 year before we got here.
Odun kan ka to de bi niyan.
That time I drive about in my Danfo bus.
Nigba yen oko Danfo mi yen mo yi ma nwa.
So they call us that this sister was sick and was dying.
Won ba pe wa pe arabinrin kan ma nja isan won ma nku lo.
So I drove there.
Won ba wa oko na de be.
I had that kind of time then. There is no time now again.
Nigba yen aye yi wa dada ni rusin aye osi mo.
I drove there.
Mo de be.
And I got to this hospital.
Wa de le iwosan yen.
Where they put her in a ward where they expect them to die.
If it won fi si ward room ward awon ti won ti pa ti pe dandan ni ka wele iku
put them there.
Oko won fi si be.
This sister has been lying on that bed for 13 weeks.
Arabirin yen ti dubule sori akete nbe fun ose meta la.
13 weeks
ose meta la
just on one side
legbe kan.
She has developed bed sore.
Ara re ti bere si bu.
So I got there 11 o'clock.
Odebe ni ago mokanla.
I could see out through the window.
Latoju ferese bayi ni mo tin garun wo.
So as I tried to enter through the door.
Mo ma gbianju lati gba enu lekun wole.
There was a man at the door.
Ogbe ni kan wa lenu lekun.
Excuse me sir. Where do you think you are going?
Ibo le le ro pe nlo.
I want to see somebody.
Mo ni mo fe reyan kan be yen.
This is not visiting time.
Ki se akoko ati wa be won
wole. Visiting time is 4 o'clock.
Ago merin na ma nbe yan wo.
But the person I was seeing at the front.
Igbe ni temi nwo ni waju.
She would die before that 4 o'clock.
Ko to dago merin ni ibaku.
I said ah.
Bani ah.
What do I do now?
Kini ki wa se bayi.
And I prayed.
Mo ba gbadura.
Said father.
Baba.
Take this man away from this door.
E ba mi mo okunrin kuro mbi lekun yo.
So I can enter.
Ki ba le raye wole.
All of a sudden.
Lojiji.
I just had her.
Mo ba gbo.
I just had him.
Mo ba gbo okunrin na.
He called his colleague.
O pe egbe re.
Sir Richard.
Hey Richard.
I may be looking at this place. I'm going to the toilet.
Ma ba mi wo bi yo. Mo fe lo gbonse.
So he went off.
O si lo gbonse.
That was my opportunity.
Anfani temi wa si niyan.
Just went inside.
Mo ya ra wole sira.
And I went straight to the bed of this sister.
Mo si lo tara si bi akete tarabirin wa.
Sat by that bed.
Mo joko si egbe re.
And started praying.
Mo ba bere si gbadura.
It was not a quiet prayer.
Ki se adura kele kele o.
Not a quiet prayer. Remember,
Jesus,
when he got to the tomb of Lazarus, he spoke to his father quietly. Father, I thank you. Because you always hear me. And then, he turned to the grave. When he turned to the grave, the Bible says, he cried in a loud voice. Lazarus!
Lazarus!
Come forth! He raised his voice. At that level, when he was addressing the spirit of death and hell, it was no longer a quiet affair. Lazarus!
Lazarus!
Come forth! Thank God he just mentioned Lazarus. If he said, come forth! Everybody in the graveyard will wake up. Because he is the resurrection and the life. Amen.
Amen.
So I'm going to pray. Loud prayer. You don't get into the places where they have condemned everybody to death and you are praying quietly. As I was praying, I was hearing the voice of the sister. Amen.
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 I continue praying. Our voice was getting louder. Amen.
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 After some time, she was struggling to stand up. Then she was able to sit up. Something she has not done in 30 weeks. She stood up and sat beside me. I was saying, Amen. Amen. I did not know that all the other patients, they were watching us. But I kept my eyes closed and I was praying. All of a sudden, throughout the word, I said, Amen.
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 In the
word.
And I kept praying there. As they were saying Amen, they were getting up. Amen.
Amen.
All of a sudden,
Lord,
the man at the door came inside.
Hey!
Ah! How did you enter?
Get out!
I said, thank you. I can get out now. But you see, the woman I was praying for was surprised. Those in the hospital too, they were surprised. But what they did not know was that my own surprise was more. Because I was praying for just one person. I did not mention the others' names. And the power of God took that prayer like insecticide spray.
I
was spraying it all over the place. The testimony of that woman gave back to other testimonies. I see somebody here tonight. Your testimony shall give rise to other testimonies. In the name of Jesus, let our amen run.